If you're thinking about doing a double major in college, then I strongly recommend watching the video to the end. You can find out how I did my double major and all the things that I wish I knew because it would have made my life a lot easier. How's it going, everyone? It's Brian. If you followed this channel enough, then you might know that I did a double major in mathematics and actuarial science. I also did a minor in statistics. So with that, I gained a lot of wisdom I hope I can pass along to you if you want to do a sort of similar thing. Number one, the thing I wish I knew about double majoring or more was that it actually can be pretty easy to do, easy, if you do it the right way. I think a lot of people get this idea in their head that a double major means completing two full degrees, and that's just like way too much to try to do in 4 years. But in reality, it's really not as much as you think, especially if the classes are similar. For instance, with what I did, actuarial science, math, and statistics, they're all so similar, they have so many overlapping things, it made it very easy to do this double major minor sort of thing. Not to mention, all of your gen eds, your general education courses, you only need to take those once. You don't need to take twice as many general education courses. You just need your regular amount. The only thing you're really doubling in is the major specific classes for your major. And as I said, if you pick majors that are pretty similar or just blend well together, you're gonna have a lot easier time of it than if you do two majors that are just completely unrelated. Which brings me to my second point, which are cross-list classes. If you don't know what a cross-listed class is, it's a class that will count towards both degrees. For example, if you had a math and a physics double major, there's probably a few courses that are math/physics, or that they will count towards both of your degrees. It counts as a math class and it counts as a physics class. When I was doing my degrees, there were many classes that were math stats, so they counted towards a mathematics degree, and they also counted towards a statistics degree. So when I took those classes, it was really easy to get my statistics minor. I essentially got it for free because I was careful in how I picked my classes. I picked as many of these cross-listed classes as I could that counted towards math and statistics, and with doing almost no extra work, I think maybe I needed like 4 or 5 extra credits, really just one or maybe two classes to get this extra statistics minor absolutely free. So if your college or university offers these cross-list classes and you want a double major, then I strongly suggest looking into those, talk with your advisor. The third thing I wish I knew was planning makes absolutely all the difference. If you're good at planning and staying organized, you can do this much easier than just doing it on the fly. I would say if you're the type of person who just meets with your advisor before you schedule your classes every semester, that's not enough prep and planning to double major, in my opinion. I'm sure you can do it, but for me, I had laid out all my courses, my course schedules, more or less until I graduated. So I did that sort of 2 years in advance, and that gave me a very clear picture of what I was going to do and the courses I need to take, the order I needed to take them. You know, some courses were only offered in the fall or in the spring. Made sure I got all my cross-list courses in there. So through this planning process, I got a lot of clarity. I really saw what was going to be the easy semesters, the hard semesters, and it was a lot easier when I took it to my advisor and showed them, hey, this is my plan, you know, what do you think? So if I could go back, I would have started planning from day one, maybe not day one, but semester one, maybe before semester one. If you can plan your double major, the earlier the better, you're gonna have such an easier time of it. The fourth thing I wish I knew was it's going to be hard to explain your plan to someone. You know, advisors don't deal with too many students that want a double major. They're just mostly focusing on students who want to pursue a single major and make sure they get all their courses scheduled. It's probably more of an unusual thing when you go to your advisor with your plan in hand, till you graduate, where you have all your classes picked out and you say, yeah, I want a double major. Your advisor might be a little taken aback. They might not really know what to say, and they might not really recommend it, you know, depending on your advisor, how well they know you. I remember when I had everything planned out and I was showing teachers or my advisors, and I had like three different plans, three different options, how I wanted to do things with different double major choices. You know, the professors and the teachers, they really didn't know what to say. I think I was looking for some sort of approval, some sort of, do you think this is a good idea? What do you recommend? And it was kind of hard to get advice from them because it was such a different situation than they're usually dealing with. So I really wish I knew that there's just not a whole lot of people that you're going to be able to talk to and get advice about this sort of thing, unless you have some fellow classmates that are double majoring and going through the same thing. The fifth thing I wish I knew before I did a double major was about summer courses. Now, obviously, if you want to finish in 4 years and you want to do a double major or more, taking summer classes can be a really great thing, can really smooth out your process, take some load off during your fall and spring semesters. But one thing I didn't know was that if you take summer classes at a university different than yours, those grades that you get in those summer classes might not count. Now, you probably can transfer the credits as long as your university approves that college and that college's class for whatever you're trying to do. But in my situation, when I had transfer credits, the credits transferred, but the grade did not. Say if there's a really hard class you want to take and it's at an approved community college near your home, you could take that class over the summer, pass it with a C, and then transfer the credit, but the C won't affect your GPA. It just kind of goes in as ungraded, but you get the credit, you get to pass the class. Now, that was just my case. I don't think that's standard across every university, so obviously you'll have to check up on that yourself, but man, I wish I knew that going in. I could have taken much stress off myself if I had gone and taken those harder courses at, say, an easier college over the summer and just focused on that and just worried about passing and then transferring the grade in would have saved me a lot of effort. The sixth thing I wish I knew about double majoring is that you're not going to impress people or make people like you when you tell them that's what you're doing. In fact, you might even come off like a jerk, you might even come off pretentious. Like you're attention seeking, or you're just trying to show off how smart and dedicated you are. I remember when I was doing my double major, I thought it was a cool thing, you know, I thought it was a unique thing, and I wanted to share it with people, and I probably came off a little worse than I meant to. So my advice is, if you're going to do a double major and people ask you what your major is, just tell them what your main major is. You know, if you were going to do a math physics major, you know, just tell them you're a math major. Or if you're doing engineering and computer science, you know, just tell them you're an engineering major. Now, of course, you're welcome to share that information. I'm sure your close friends and family will know that you're going to do a double major. But in my experience, it's just a little bit better to be more humble. The seventh thing I wish I knew before double majoring was that employers aren't gonna care as much as you want them to. I thought doing a double major and a minor was going to get me all of these jobs and impress every employer I ever saw, and I really don't know that it did that. I think probably employers want you to have a major in the field you want to be employed in, have decent grades. Experience is probably the most valid factor. I think employers would much rather have someone with one degree and a year of experience in the job rather than someone with two degrees. You know, when it comes down to it, graduating college to an employer, it's sort of just a mark of competency. You know, a lot of times now, what you're learning in school, you won't necessarily be doing it on the job. So if you have a double major to an employer, I don't know how much extra benefit that is. It's sort of just saying like, yeah, you got through college a little bit better, but how much more does it help the company? It's something to keep in mind that if you're really trying to get a great job, just doing a double major might not be the only thing to do. You probably want to get some real world experience, maybe an internship, something like that. That being said, it is kind of a cool thing that may make you a little bit unique and might differentiate you a little bit. I just wouldn't rely on it too much. The eighth thing I wish I knew before I started double majoring was that it can actually be pretty addicting. When I was doing all the planning and when I was doing all the research, you know, scheduling my courses and seeing what different majors I wanted to do, you know, it was really tempting to see all my options and just keep adding things. You know, oh, if I take two more classes here, I can get this. Or, ah, I bet if I just squeeze this in this semester, that'll give me this extra major, extra certification. It got to a point where I was just trying to accomplish these wild, unrealistic timelines and goals for almost no reason other than I guess I thought it sounded cool. So I would recommend just keeping it in mind that if you want to do a double major, that's fantastic. Just make sure you don't try to keep on doubling and doubling that and doubling the next thing and adding on just a ridiculous amount of courses because you want all these degrees. You probably are going to find that if you just add two more classes, you can get this minor, or, oh, just add five classes and you can get another major. It can be very tempting, but you are going to want to watch out for my ninth point. The ninth thing I wish I knew before I double majored in college was you might actually want to double down on what you really want to do. I know for me, double majoring left me very stressed out. And not to mention, I did absolutely nothing with my second major other than get an internship. And that was before I even graduated. Before you really decide to double major, you probably want to consider what you're actually going to do when you graduate. What's the reason you're going to do this double major? Can you do what you want to do with only one degree and save yourself all that time and energy just doing one major? Maybe you can even get better at your single major and really make yourself an expert in that field rather than splitting up your concentration between two different things. Just consider what you want in the end, what you want to do when you graduate before you make one decision or the other. Hey, I picked out this video just for you. I think you're gonna like it. And if you got something out of this video, I would really appreciate a like on it. It really helps out this channel. It helps out with the YouTube algorithm more than you would believe. Anyway, I hope you have a great day.